There's a lot of people confused as to something that really isn't confusing, but recently we learned that James Gunn is executive producer on Avengers Endgame. You know, that movie that's coming out that he really wasn't involved with and was fired when they were post-producing it. So, why? Well, it's kind of a simple answer, I guess. So, obviously, James Gunn was fired, then hired by Warner Brothers, then rehired by Disney. And he's going to do Guardians, but he was gone. And why is he being given credit on Endgame when he never touched it, right? A lot of people are finding this confusing. So, to kind of make this clear for you guys, the Guardians of the Galaxy have a huge role to play in Endgame, as they did in Infinity War and going forward. James Gunn was the one that was brought on, and he established who these characters are. It was his vision, his version, and his voice. They're using those characters that he brought to the table, right? They're not different. They're not new versions of the Guardians. So they have to give him credit because he came up with these characters, their designs, their ideas, their personalities, everything. So he's given the executive producer, you know, title. If you look at Marvel movies, Stan Lee's credited with every single one of them. If you remember in 2013, when they asked Stan Lee what he thought of the Guardians of the Galaxy, he didn't know who they were. He had no idea who the Guardians were, because he never once worked on them or anything like that at the time. It was just like, oh, the Guardians, I don't know. But he's still listed right there as producer, right? Because he created the Marvel Universe, so this is something that's ongoing. So that's kind of how it's going to be with the cosmic side of things with James Gunn. But now he's back, so it doesn't really matter. You know, he's going to stick around. But that's kind of how it is going forward. So when you look at it that way, that's why into the future, when they go with, like, producing the X-Men movies, right? You're still going to have people responsible for the Fox X-Men credited under the Marvel Studios brand. It's confusing, I know, even if they never lend a hand on them. Remember Chris Nolan in Man of Steel? He literally walked on set once, looked at the script and said, "Don't have Superman snap a neck." And then walked out, and he was executive producer, and he was all over the titles and trailers. He literally did one visit, one day. So, you know, studios can stretch that.